Black Friday has fast become one of the country's biggest sales periods, with about $250 million worth of transactions last year.
But are we really getting a genuine bargain? Or are retailers playing fast and loose with sale pricing?
The Black Friday sales are just around the corner, kicking off next Friday, the 25th of November. With inflation hitting Kiwis hard, the bargains will be welcome, and we're ready.
I might get a new umbrella.
Shoes, clothes.
I probably will go to Costco then.
Well, most of us are.
Are you going to buy anything this coming Black Friday?
No.
Why not?
Because I hate that sort of carry-on.
According to Price Spy, more than half of us are planning to purchase, and on average, we'll spend more than $700. Doesn't even start this Friday. But before you hand over your credit card, be warned, not all the sales are genuine bargains. So how can you make sure you don't get Friday fleeced?
And Paul Smith from Consumer New Zealand is here now. Lovely to see you, Paul. Tell us, what is a genuine sale item and what isn't?
It's sometimes quite hard to tell. The stores will tell you everything's a genuine sale item, but we've found that a lot of products are actually on sale or at a reasonable discount for a lot of the year. So the advice is really to do your research before you go in and don't fall for what they're saying.
Yes, you do recommend that people do their research, Paul, but how do you find out previous prices?
Two great sites to look at are Price Me and Price Spy, and they have tracking information for pretty much all the stores that you can go into, and you can look at a price history over the last year or two and see just when those products have been on sale.
And what do you recommend you do? Do you go to that retailer and go, look, that's not a proper sale price, knock some more money off?
Yeah, absolutely. Our buyer here says don't accept the price if you think you can get it less. The worst they can do is just refuse to give you more discount. Even if you've bought something and you go in afterwards and find that it's now on sale, you can go in and ask for that discount. And you know, worst case, they're not going to do it, but it's worth a go.
And what else do people need to watch out for around these kinds of sale periods, Paul?
One of the things I've found through my own experience is you've got to be careful that the store you're looking at is comparable to other stores. So a lot of times you'll find that some products are actually cheaper at other stores usually than places that have got them and advertising them as a big discount.
I mean, I'd never heard of Black Friday 10 years ago. I don't think most of us had. I know it was a big thing in the US. It's certainly over here and everywhere now. Why have these sales days grown so much in popularity?
I don't know. We've found that so many stores seem to have constant sales. It's almost, in some cases, it's nearly every weekend. Black Friday has now grown into Black Week, and I saw a couple of retailers have even turned it into Black Month now. So the whole thing's rolling into November, and then we're straight into Boxing Day sales, which actually start before Christmas now, into January sales. So yeah, it's just a constant push to keep people buying, I think, at this time of year.
Thank you, Paul. Appreciate your time tonight.
Thank you. You're welcome.